Loruko Jesu.
Amen.
Loruko Jesu.
Amen.
Loruko nla Jesu.
Amen.
Olorun wa yin ologo fun bi to ran wa lowode. Olu agba pe wa.
Amen.
Olu agba yin wa.
Amen.
Olorun wa adufi to ni ile olowo. Olu agba akoso.
Amen.
Awa oluso emi olu agbe wa wo.
Amen.
Gbogbo awon olugbo emi olu agbe won wo.
Amen.
Ki won fe ti emi gbo.
Amen.
Ki won fi oke mi gba.
Amen.
Lopin aye wa atoluso atolugbo ka gokere orun keta.
Amen.
Ka jalaye lai lai.
Amen.
Loruko Jesu Oluwa wa.
Amen.
Ni ose to koja
last week we read some Bible references which the users thought or think that are against that great truth that at the end of our lives as Christians that we go up to heaven, the place of life and glory. The Bible references which we read, we paraphrased them and explained them. We cited the Bible references and we told you, our hearers, to read through them by yourselves because we had little time to read and explain them. But by the grace of God, today, we want to use one of the Bible references that we used last week. When we used it last week, as I said earlier, we didn't read it. But today, we want to read the Bible reference. We want to read it because the verse contains very powerful truths. And we think we should read and explain. The Bible reference is the Revelation, chapter 6, verses 9 to 11. I said it contains some very powerful points. And that's why we must read it so that you, our hearers, will hear it. Now open to the Bible reference. And as we have prayed earlier, what we will read there and which we will explain. Hear it with spiritual ears. And receive it with spiritual
ears.
Now let's be attentive. Chapter 6, verses 9 to 11 of the book of Revelation.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Oh, yes. 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 Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. As if he has
yes.
As if we fun
yes.
Kewan kyo se medi igbadiye na.
Oh yes.
Titi ye awan iran shay legbe ati arakunrin won ti a o pa bi won yo fi pe.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okan awon idi.
One of the reasons for which I said we would read this place to our hearing is that it's a book of revelation. It's the word of God. That 2 Corinthians chapter 12 that we are reading and explaining, some say it is mere dream. that anyone could have a dream. Therefore, it is not what we can go by. Though what Paul said was he was caught up to the third heaven. And like this book of Revelation, he was given a revelation. And when he got there, he met living beings who were talking. But the preachers of death and hell, who don't promote the eternal life which the Lord brought, they have brought down that Bible reference, claiming that it's a mere dream. But this book of Revelation, chapter 6, the reason I said we would read and explain it is that the Lord said something great about the book of Revelation, which any preacher who has not given his life over to the devil must not say it's a mere dream. What is that thing that the Lord said about this book of Revelation? Let's open to the Revelation chapter 1 from verse 1.
Yes.
Ìfihàn ti Jésù Kristi.
Ewé ìfihàn. Ó jẹ́ ewé ìfihàn ti Jésù Kristi.
Ti Ọlọ́run fi fún.
Ọlọ́run ló ni ewé ìfihàn tó gbélé Jésù lọ́wọ́.
Láti fi hàn fún àwọn ìránṣẹ́ rẹ̀.
Ọlọ́run ló ni ewé ìfihàn tó gbélé Jésù lọ́wọ́ kó lè fi hàn fún àwọn ìránṣẹ́ rẹ̀ láyé.
Ohun tí kò lè ṣàìṣe ní lọ́lọ́.
Àwọn ohun tó jẹ́ pé Ọlọ́run yóò ṣe tí wọ́n sì ṣe ní lọ́lọ́. Yes.
Ó sì ránṣẹ́.
Jésù náà ránṣẹ́.
Ó sì fi hàn láti ọwọ́ áńgẹ́lì rẹ̀ wá fún Jòhánù.
Ọ̀nà àgbẹ̀ ìwé ìfihàn. Jésù náà àgbẹ̀ ìwé ìfihàn ní áńgẹ́lì rẹ̀ lọ́wọ́. Áńgẹ́lì náà wá gbé lé Jòhánù lọ́wọ́.
Ìránṣẹ́ rẹ̀.
Jòhánù ti ṣe ìránṣẹ́ Olúwa. Báyìí gẹ́gẹ́ bí a sì ká yìí.
Just as we have read that verse,
nífi orí kíní yìí,
in this Revelation chapter 1,
látẹ̀sẹ̀ kíní yìí,
from verse 1,
Ọlọ́run wí pé,
dear God says,
Ọlọ́run ló ní ìwé ìfihàn,
it's he God who owns the book of Revelation,
tó ń gbélé Jésù Olùgbàlà lọ́wọ́,
and he gave it to Jesus the Savior,
tí Jésù náà gbélé áńgẹ́lì lọ́wọ́,
Jesus in turn gave it to an angel,
táńgẹ́lì náà gbélé Jọ́hánù Apọ́sítélì lọ́wọ́,
and the angel gave it to the apostle John.
Kí àwa ọmọ Ọlọ́run láyé.
So that we children of God on the earth.
Kálẹ̀ mọ́ tó rá sọ pé òun ó ṣe ní lọ́lọ́.
Might know what the Lord had proposed to do shortly.
Torí ìdí èyí.
Because of this.
Gbogbo tí a bá kà.
All the things we read.
Nínú orí ìfihàn tí a fẹ́ kà yìí.
In this reference in the Revelation that we want to read.
Ká ti pé Ọlọ́run sọ pé ìwé òun Ọlọ́run ni.
Let's remember that God says it is his book.
Tó ń gbélé Jésù Olùgbàlà lọ́wọ́.
Which he gave to Jesus the Savior.
Jésù náà gbélé áńgẹ́lì lọ́wọ́.
And which Jesus the Lord gave to his angel.
Áńgẹ́lì wá fún Jọ́hánù Apọ́sítélì láti fún àwa ọmọ Ọlọ́run láyé.
And the angel gave it to John in order to give it to us, his children on the earth.
Torí ìdí èyí.
Because of this.
Ọ̀rọ̀ tí a máa kà nínú ìwé ìfihàn yìí lónìí.
What we shall read today in this book of Revelation. And which we will explain.
Bí a bá lọ rí oníwàásù kan.
We find any preacher.
Tó sọ ohunkóhun tako.
Who speaks against it?
Kọ́lántì o.
You should remember.
Pọ́n tako Ọlọ́run ẹlẹ́dà.
That is speaking against God the Creator.
Tọ́lọ́run ló ní ìwé ìfihàn.
Who says he owns the book of Revelation?
Kọ́lántì pé òun tako Jésù Olùgbàlà.
Should remember that he's going against Jesus the Savior.
Tọ́lọ́run gbé ìwé ìfihàn ní lọ́wọ́.
To whom God gave the book of Revelation.
Kọ́lántì pé òun tako áńgẹ́lì mímọ́ Ọlọ́run.
You should remember that he's going against an holy angel of God.
Tọ́lọ́gbàlà gbé ìwé ìfihàn ní lọ́wọ́.
To whom the Savior gave the book of Revelation.
Ó tún tako Jọ́hánù Apọ́sítélì.
And he's going against the apostle John.
ti angel gbele lowo
to whom the angel gave it to through whom we children of God on the heart received the book of Revelation. So what we shall read today, it is a truth of Christ that is very visible. So just as we have read earlier, John said, when Jesus the Savior opened the fifth seal,
Lori,
he saw the throats of them that were killed under the altar. That is, their bodies had been killed. He said they were crying with a loud voice, as it was read earlier. They cried unto the true God. That when would he avenge their blood on those who killed them on the earth? For the word of God and for the testimony of Jesus which they held to. Then he continued there. Said they were given white robes, and they were told to rest until their fellow servants of God that would be killed as they have been killed would be complete in number. Now, what are the truths that are contained in this reference that we shall pinpoint one by one? One, as we have explained, which we have said repeatedly, the spirit is an ever-living being. Because God gave the spirit to man right from his inside. And because God is ever living, his spirit which he put in us human beings is ever living. That is our truth here. Because these ones, as we have read, they have been killed for the word of God and the testimony of Jesus that they held. That is, in the world, they had been martyred in the world. But their spirits that went out, because the spirit is living, their spirits were living beings. And as a witness that their spirits were living, as we have read in this reference, they cried with a loud voice. It's a living that could cry with a loud voice. And they were spoken to. It is only to her living we can speak and we hear. They were given words of comfort. It's a living that could understand what comfort is. And they were given robes. It's a living that could be given a robe. And when they were given robes, that when it is given a robe, it will be speaking to you. That you who have been given a robe, yes, rest for a while. Because there still remains others that will be killed like you. Yes, it's only the living ones that all this could be done to. So this revelation of God, which he gave to Jesus, shows clearly that the spirit is living. It does not die as the body dies. These matters, their bodies have died. But their spirits were living because the spirit is a living being.
Say what you see.
Furthermore, these living beings about whom we are reading here, they had not gone up to heaven. So they have not gone to the glory of heaven. They were not like the ones we read about in 2 Corinthians chapter 12.
ti awon ti guke lo si orun.
Who have gone up to the third heaven.
Ipo ku ni awon eleyi ti wa.
These ones were still in hell below.
Anake na ran pe ipo ku ni won ti wa.
And how do we know that they were still in hell?
A lo sinu we fi ba yi ori ogun.
We now go to the Revelation.
Ese kerin.
Chapter 20 verse 4.
Ne gba ta ba de be.
When we get there.
A do soro nipa won.
They have spoken of there.
Iwe fi ori ogun ese kerin ja du feti le.
Let's listen well.
Ka gbo oro Olorun ninu iwe Olorun.
And hear the word of God in the book of God. Which is said he gave to Jesus.
Yes, ese kerin.
Mo si ri awon ite.
Mo ri awon ite.
Won si joko lori won.
Won joko lori won.
A si fi idajo fun won.
A si fi idajo fun won.
Mo si ri oka awon ti abe lori nitori eri Jesu.
Mo ri oka awon ti abe lori nitori eri Jesu.
Ati nitori oro Olorun.
Ati nitori oro Olorun.
Ati awon ti ko si fori bale fun ero kan na.
Adan te fori bale fun eran ko na.
Ati fun aworan re.
Ati fun aworan re.
Tabi ti ko gbe ami re ni waju won.
Ti won ti gbe ami re ni waju won.
Ati le owo won.
Ati le owo won.
Won si wa laye.
Won wa laye.
Won si joba pelu Kristi ni egberun odun.
Won joba pelu Kristi ni egberun odun. Bani we fi ori ogun ese kerin yi.
In this Revelation chapter 20 verse 4.
Ibe le toka si awon ti apa ni fi ori kefa. Ese kese de kokala.
The Bible refers to those who are killed in the Revelation chapter 6 verses 9 to 11. In that Revelation chapter 6 verses 9 to 11, the Bible says those who are killed for the word of God and the testimony of Jesus. And on getting to the Revelation chapter 20 verse
4,
it explains that they were beheaded.
So what do you see?
Furthermore, we are made to know that they were killed during the time of the Antichrist. For in this Revelation chapter 20,
says
those who had not worshipped the beast, neither his image, neither had received his mark. So that beast refers to the Antichrist. We want to read about him in detail. Read the Revelation chapter 13, the whole chapter. There, he decreed that dwellers of the heart should receive mark, and that they should worship. So these ones that were killed in Revelation 20 verse 4, we are able to know that they will be killed during that great tribulation of the Antichrist. And we know that those who the Antichrist will kill on the earth, they are the ones who will not be caught up during the catching up of the
same.
So it is crystal clear here that they won't partake of the catching up of the saints. They won't go up to heaven. But during the reign of the Antichrist, it is then they will take their stand for Jesus. As we have read in this Revelation chapter 20, they won't receive marks on their hands or their foreheads. And as we have read in this Revelation chapter 20, it is in the descent of the Lord on the earth to stage his millennial reign. It is then the Lord will raise them out. And then they will live and partake of the millennial reign. Another truth has been seen here. In this book of God, as they cried with a loud voice in chapter 6 of the Revelation. So the king will meet them in that state. So we find them as living beings. In the Revelation chapter 6, they were given white robes. As they were clothed with their robes, in the Revelation chapter 6, the king will meet them. In the Revelation chapter 20, and he will bring them out for them to reign with him for 1,000 years. So that truth is sustained, is God's own truth. That our spirit is ever living. Their spirits are living forever. Two, it is not in the state of sleeping inactively that the Lord will find Christians who will raise up when he comes. But in a state of living beings that were crying and were given white robes, the Lord will find these ones when he comes back. Their own resurrection is that they will be removed from hell in order to reign with Jesus for 1,000 years. So in this Revelation chapter 20, which is God's own revelation, which he gave to Jesus, the Lord stamps 2 Corinthians chapter 12, that those who Paul saw in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, and he said they were living beings. In this Revelation chapter 20, the Lord confirms it, that it was the living beings that Paul saw. It's not an empty dream. That God gave his own revelation to Paul, like this one of Revelation 2, those of 2 Corinthians chapter 12, as they were speaking, Paul said they were speaking words that was unlawful for him to speak. These matters of this chapter 20 that will be killed by the Antichrist. In like manner, they were crying with a loud voice. And the Lord will find them in that state in Revelation chapter 20. So the cry of those of chapter 20 corroborates 2 Corinthians chapter 12. That truly, they were speaking words of glory, which was unlawful for Paul to speak. Like this revelation, as it is God's revelation, which God gave to John. So is 2 Corinthians chapter 12. It is God's own revelation which God gave to Paul.
So as you see,
furthermore, all the dead that the Lord will raise up when he comes back, especially those who were the just, the faithful, it is in this state they will be. They will be in the state of a living. For in this Revelation chapter 20, when the Lord descended to establish his millennial reign, these matters, this just who did not receive the mark of the Christ and did not worship him, who he will raise up to the millennial reign, he found them in the state of living beings. They were speaking and they were clothed with white robes. So this Revelation 20 shows us clearly that when the Lord will come back, all the just who he says will raise up, he won't find them sleeping in death, but we find them as living beings, like those of Revelation chapter 20. So those of 2 Corinthians chapter 12, the state they were in which God revealed to Paul, the state of living beings, the Lord will find them.
Like
those of Revelation chapter
20.
So we're emphasizing this point, that we who are God's children, the spirit in us, which God gave to us, is a living spirit. It abides forever. The spirit does not die as the body dies. The spirit is ever living. And two, those of us who belong to Jesus the Savior, we shall be living with him. The Holy Spirit, which who he gave us, the Holy Spirit, it's not the life of death, but of life. The Holy Spirit, who he gave to us his children, by whom we became children of God. That's John chapter 1, verse 12. The Spirit by whom we became God's children. Romans chapter 8, verse 14 through 16. The Spirit by whom we became children of God.
Is
the spirit of life, of God, of Christ, and of heaven. So like those of 2 Corinthians chapter 12, whose spirits are living. So they were speaking in the third heaven above.
Two,
they belonged to Jesus. When their lives ended on the earth, the spirit of Jesus took them up. The Holy Spirit, the spirit of Jesus took them up in the third heaven, so that truth is sustained. And we're emphasizing it, that we children of God, our spirit, which God gave us, if we use it to follow Jesus to the end of our lives, we don't backslide, we don't renounce our faith, if we are faithful in the faith of God, like those of 2 Corinthians chapter 12, when our lives here will end,
it
is not death who will carry us. We do not belong to death again. We won't descend to hell below. We are not candidates of hell again. But like the word of Jesus the Savior, in John chapter 8, verse 51, truly, truly, he promises us that anyone who keeps his word will never see death. John chapter 8, verse 51, that anyone who keeps his word will never see death. So we who have believed in him, he will learn his words, and by obeying his words, we follow him to the end. According to his promise, we will never see death. But like those who were in the third heaven, our spirits that are ever living, are heaven above, the spirit of God will put us, will take us
to.
For I say again, the Holy Spirit, the spirit of Christ, the spirit of God, that is Romans chapter 8 verse 9, the spirit of Christ, the spirit of God, is the Holy Spirit. When our life's air will end, the spirit of Christ that made us children of God, even above with Christ,
he
will take us to. This is the promise of God in the Bible, that we who belong to Christ, we should forget death forever. We will never, never see death. When our lives here will end, in the face of God, our spirits will go up to heaven by the deed of the Holy Spirit, whom Jesus Jesus gave us. And who made us children of God. Like those of 2 Corinthians chapter 12. Will be clothed with a garment of light. White robes. Will be clothed with. And in it we go up to the third heaven. Our hasty body. That is earthly garment. The Lord will put it off.
Aso fufu.
Yes, white robes.
Aso iye.
The garment of life.
Tiseti aso ti oke orun.
Which is that of heaven.
Nolu ayo si fun wa wa na.
The Lord will clothe us with.
Ifi ori kefa mi.
In the Revelation chapter 6.
Ese kesande kokala.
Verses 9 to 11.
Ati aso di yo pa.
Those who the Antichrist will
kill. Ti yo
be
lori.
Who he will be head.
Nigba eponju.
During the great tribulation.
To ba je pe afun ni aso fufu.
If they were given white robes.
Tori mo le ku mo.
Because they could not die again.
Ati be mo lo ninu aye.
They have been beheaded on the earth.
Emi won te jade ku ninu ara.
Their spirits have left their bodies.
Won te wa ni ipo oku.
They were in hell.
Nibi to lu ako won si.
Where the Lord put them.
To ba je pe emi won to nbe ni ipo oku.
If their spirits that were in hell.
Nigba ti aso
after the Antichrist had killed them, if the spirits would be clothed with white robes, and they would be in the white robes until the Lord will come back in the Revelation chapter 20 to put them in the millennial reign. How much more we who belong to him, who belong to him to the end, and he puts up our hasty bodies, and he takes us up to heaven. That's not heaven. Which was revealed to Paul. It is not in nakedness. He will put us in heaven. He will clothe us with white robes. The garment of life. That we won't die again forever. That forever we live.
He
will give us that garment of life. That we clothe with and go to the place of life in the third heaven. So take note of this Revelation chapter 6 verses 9 to 11 and Revelation chapter 20 verse 4. As we said at the beginning of this teaching,
that
is God's own revelation which God gave to Jesus, which he gave to his angel,
and
the angel gave to John. So this is true sin. This Revelation chapter 6, which we have highlighted. And we said all the truths corroborate 2 Corinthians chapter 12. We who claim to have believed in God as a creator and Jesus as our Savior. And we know that the holy angels are God's servants and we receive John as an apostle of God. The revelations in 2 Corinthians 12, which the Lord corroborates in his Revelation chapter 6,
let's
receive them and live by them. We who are preachers, let's teach them to our congregation that if they believe in Jesus as their Savior and belong to him to the end of their lives, according to the promise of the Lord in John chapter 8 verse 51, that they will never see death. And whoever doesn't see death forever will not descend to hell below. Whoever doesn't see death forever, like those of 2 Corinthians 12,
he'll
be clothed with a garment of life,
he'll
be clothed with the heavenly garment, by the deed of the Spirit of Jesus, the Spirit of life, the Spirit of heaven, the Holy Spirit, who made him his children, the child of God, and who indwells
him.
He will be taken up to heaven.
So
we find any child of God who has a sure testimony that his life ends
sinu Jesu olugbala,
in Jesus the Savior,
sinu irele Jesu,
in the gospel of Jesus,
sinu igbagbo Jesu,
in the faith of Jesus.
Kristi enu iku lo susi,
he doesn't sleep in death.
Gaga bi asiri ifihan ori kefa,
as the revelation we have got in chapter 6
adokande kejo ori kejila,
and 2 Corinthians chapter 6
supan iru eni be,
but such a fellow
to je ti Jesu dopin,
who belongs to dopin, Jesus to the end,
gaga bi leri oluwa,
according to the promise of the Lord,
kori iku,
he doesn't see death, and he won't go down to hell, but he will be cut up to heaven, like those of Jesus who are of the Old Testament, who are saints, who he removed and took to heaven after he had resurrected, like the Apostle Paul, to whom the Lord showed heaven, like John. The Lord took John to heaven itself. In this revelation chapter
4.
In this God's revelation. This revelation of Jesus. Chapter
4.
John the apostle was taken to the throne of God. And he described the glory of God. He described the glory of the throne of God. He described the glory of the four living creatures. The glorious cherubim and glorious seraphim. He described all of them.
So
all of us who belong to Jesus the Savior, according to the word of Jesus, in John chapter 5, verse 24, we have passed from death into life by the redemption work of Jesus the Savior. Because of this, right from this moment, all of us preachers and all of us children of God who have listened to the revelation chapter 6, verses 9 to 11, which we have used to 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 1 to 5. We have had it. Let's receive the great thing which the Lord has come to do for us, the gospel, the good news of great joy which the Lord has come to give us. Let's accept it, that in Jesus we are living, while living in the world, and when our bodies die and our spirits that are living go out of the bodies, we are living forever, and we'll be given 3 categories of glory. Immediately we come out of our bodies, we'll be given 3 categories of glory as we have seen. 1, we will go up to heaven. Anyone who goes up to heaven, that's a great glory.
Yes.
One of our people that we know very well, we know that he has died physically. He's not in the world again. Maybe 14 years ago, like that of Paul, that he had died physically as a child of Jesus the Savior. And we have not seen him since then. After about 14 years, on a broad daylight, if he appears in our living room where we sit, if he appears in our living room and it's one we know very well, maybe our mother or our father or our elder, it's somebody we know very well, and he appears all of a sudden in our living room where we are on a broad daylight, shall we say it's like us? Will he be like us exactly? No.
So what do you see?
Furthermore, what are we going to do?
How did you?
Yes, we will tremble.
How did you?
We shiver and tremble by the grace of Jesus. If the Lord inspires us and we have peace of mind, and he begins to address us, the one who comes down from the third heaven, if he speaks to us, after speaking to us,
He says, therefore,
abide in Jesus to the end.
I
came down from heaven
in 2
Corinthians chapter 12 that you have been taught.
I
came down from that third heaven, from Paul, from Peter, from John, and other saints. So practice the faith to the end. If God does it, I have come to fire you so that you practice that faith to the end.
It
says, let us pray.
It
says, then pray.
And we
say in Jesus' name. And for him to say amen. In Jesus' name. It says amen. Suddenly, we don't hear his voice again. And we open our eyes. And we don't see him again. Is he not a man of glory? So anyone who goes up to the third heaven, as we have read in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, which the Lord corroborates, in the Revelation chapter 6, as we have read it there, ascension to heaven, when we put off our bodies, is a great glory. And we also said it there. Those who will be killed by the Antichrist, who will not go up to heaven, at the catching of the saints, and they will descend to hell. When it is when the Lord returns for his millennial reign, they will remove them to the millennial reign. If they could be clothed, because white robe signifies life. They are living things. How much more? Those of us whose lives end in Jesus, and we are taken up to the third heaven, that we won't be clothed with white robes. The second glory. We whose bodies have been removed, whose antibodies have been removed, and we are clothed with a garment of light, the garment of heaven, in which we will be able to go to the third heaven. That garment of life, is it not glory? Is it not glory? The third glory. And for us to get up to heaven, there, and
to
see the saints, the departed saints, Peter,
Daniel,
and the rest of them,
who Paul said
they were speaking in heaven,
which
the Lord has corroborated, that truly they were speaking, because those in Revelation also were speaking.
We
now see the patriarchs who have gone before, who are speaking. And we now join their company. Is that not great glory? Is that not great glory?
So what you see?
Furthermore, and for us to know that the place we are in is where the Lord referred to as the Father's house. That we are no longer in the world again. That we are one of the heavens that belong to God. For in John 14, dear Jesus says, in my Father's house, there are many mansions. Where is the Father's house? Heaven. That is in heaven. There are many heavens. In heaven, the Father's house, there are many heavens. Copious Bible verses that we read later reveal to us clearly that the heavens of God are many.
Now,
one of the heavens of God is the third heaven. And for us to be conscious, to be aware that we are already in one of the heavens of God, is that not great glory?
So what you see?
Furthermore, for us to be aware that once the Lord comes to meet us here, where we are, where we are speaking, like those of Revelation chapter 6, where we are, and we are living beings, like those of Revelation chapter 6, that when the Lord comes here now, he will take us to the throne to wed us to himself.
So
is that not great glory? There are other kinds of glory that God will permit us to see.
tori akoko wa ti lo,
because our time is fast spent,
lagbara Olorun,
by the power of
God, gagabi ileri wa,
according to our promise
lose okoja
last week,
ani awon ese ti ku,
we said we still have more verses
to je pa kan ro pe o tako iwa laye awon nigbagbo,
which some think are against,
nigba ta ba jade laye,
the livingness of Christians when we depart this world, we said we still read them
lati fi apo ti won ka ni oye won,
to show that it's what they read they don't understand,
pe awon nigbagbo o,
that we believers
ba ba jade laye
o, once we depart this world
alaye ni wa laye.
We are ever living beings. We are coming to read them.
So what do you see?
Furthermore, this Revelation chapter 6, verses 9 to 11. And this Revelation chapter 20, verse 4. We are not done yet. We are not done yet with the explanation that
time
first. So come next week. We continue in our explanation. Before we read other Bible references. So to conclude, that came from the inside of God into house.
Spirit,
is ever living spirit that could not die. If we now accept Jesus, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Christ, the Spirit of God, who he gave us when we believed in him and made us children of God, is ever living spirit. Not a spirit of hell again.
The body of Adam.
Led us to hell.
When Adam committed sin.
According to John 3:13, which we read last week, so the body of Adam, which we received when we were born into the world, led us to hell. But the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Christ, will take our own spirit that is ever living to Christ in the third heaven. So it's a good news of great joy that all children of God who belong to Jesus, when our lives are done in the faith, and the Lord has not returned, we put off our earthly tabernacles, the Adamic garment will be removed that leads to hell, and be clothed with the Holy Spirit, the garment of Jesus, the garment of life, and we swear up to the third heaven. That is the truth of Christ that is visible in the Revelation chapter 6, verses 9 to 11, and Revelation chapter 20, verse 4. Next week, as we said earlier, we will continue. Lord, we thank you for today. Receive
us.
We speak us and the hearer. By this world, when our lives here will end, let's go
up
to the third heaven, in the cloth of heaven, in the garment of life, let's be living in there, and live forever. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen.
Lati ju afupe Kristi lati mu eko ti esese gbo tan ye wa se ti gbo yin oni wa so yin ni oluso agotan je o olugare ti e ba ni ibeere lori eko yi e le fe atejise ranse si number yi
odo ejo okan odo ejo odo meta to telera won eta arun okan le kan si odo ejo okan odo ejo odo meta to telera won eta arun okan
e kiyesi atejise nikan ni o e ma pe e ma se gbagbe lati fi oruko yin ati ibi ti e wa si lati mo awon ibi ti e ka wa wa ni osogbo ile ife Ibadan Akure Eko Ikare Adu Ekiti atawon ilu miran e fi atejise yin ranse si
odo ejo okan odo ejo odo meta to telera won eta arun okan
e darapo mo wa fun wakati irere ayo nla ni asiko yi kan na lo se ko nbo.
The message you have just listened to was brought to you by Christ's Trumpeters Church, Ilesha, Osun State. The preacher was Pastor J. O. Omidare. If you have any questions on this message, you can send a text or WhatsApp message only to 0810-800-0351. That is 0810-800-0351. Take note, do not call. Send a text or WhatsApp message only. Remember to add your name and location. To locate our branches in Oshogbo, Ile-Ife, Ibadan, Akure, Lagos, Ikare, and other towns and cities, send a text message to 0810-800-0351. Join us for another edition of the Good News of Great Joy. Same time next week. God bless you.
Shit, I won't move.